Hello and welcome to the Fixit Shed. So a few weeks ago I needed a new light for a video that I was working on, so I had this fixture and I put a bulb in it and attached an extension cord to it. Now the only problem is the extension cord doesn't have a switch, so as soon as you plug it in it turns on. So I went online, bought an inline switch for the extension cord, and I'm going to add that to it today so that I can turn it on and off. Alright. So these are the switches that I bought, so let's open them up and see what I got here. Just a simple on-off toggle switch. I need a screwdriver. Let's open that up. It looks like you can use either a Phillips or regular screwdriver. All right, so we've got strain relief on each side and two terminals on each side to connect the wires to. All right, so I need to determine where I want the switch to be. I'm gonna have it just be a couple of feet away from the light. I don't want it too far, so I'm just gonna cut it right here. Always make sure that it's unplugged when you're working on it. So we're gonna cut there. All right, so now I'm gonna remove the screws for the strain relief. Alright, so I don't know if you can see down in there, but there's a hole that we can feed the wire right in and then tighten these screws down. So I'm gonna loosen them up to make sure that we're not obstructing the hole. Okay. So those are both open. And now I'm gonna just strip a little bit of the insulation off of each of the ends of the wires. Alright, so you could tin the ends of these and put some solder on them, but I'm just going to twist them up. Okay, and we're going to just insert one in here. Bend it. There we go. That one's fed in. I'm going to tighten the screw down. All right, I'm going to do the same for the other side. Inserted. Tighten the screw down. Make sure those are both tight. Okay. All right, now I'm gonna put the strain relief on. This is gonna put pressure on the wire so that if this gets tugged on, it won't pull on where the connections are. That one started. Let's get the other one started. All right. So that should hold the wire pretty tight. And we're just going to do the same to the other side. Strip a little bit of the insulation off. Right, twist them up. Okay. Oh, let me get the strain relief out of the way. Get these screws loosened up and out of the way. All right, so there is a smooth wire and a rough wire with the insulation, and so I am gonna keep those matched up, right? We have the rough wire on this side, the smooth wire on that side, and rough wire here, smooth wire here. So kind of set up the same. Okay. Those wires inserted. We're going to tighten the screws down. So this is actually a fairly substantial switch compared to what I'm used to seeing. Usually they just have the little blades that cut into the wires. They don't usually have terminals that have screws on them. This is actually pretty nice. I don't like it. All right, that's tight. Let's get the cover back on. Tighten these up. Okay. And we can plug it in. Yeah, it works. All right, so I've got the inline switch installed on the light, and I'm actually pretty pleased with the quality of these switches, so I'm gonna put a link to them in the description. So if you enjoyed this video, please be sure to subscribe. And if you're interested in becoming a member, click the join button below the video. Thanks for watching, take care.